look, what's there?
Research opportunities. How do you get those? Well, let's find out.
Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. So yesterday I uploaded the first to the Stanford Student Series, where seven of my friends in the Stanford class of 2024 revealed their extracurriculars that got them into Stanford. And a lot of them ended up doing research, and a lot of you guys asked how to land research opportunities. So in this video, we're gonna cover exactly that. So the first tip I have for landing research opportunities is to search online for programs that match high school students with institutions looking for interns. And I actually participated in one of these programs in Oregon and Washington State. We have a program called Apprenticeship in Science and Engineering. So I basically submitted my cover letters through that program, and I believe they have about a 30% acceptance rate. And they basically accept students, and then they match the student up with a mentor who is either a professor at a university or somebody who is working at a corporate firm. So where I live, we have HP, Hewlett-Packard, I believe, and some students were matched to an internship for research at HP. However, these programs do vary by region and physical location, so depending on where you live, you may or may not have one of these programs. So just in case you don't have one of these programs, or if the deadline for these programs have passed, don't worry, you have other options as well. So tip number two for finding and landing research opportunities is to cold email. This is a direct quote from Inez, who is my friend from Spain who did research at Stanford University before she was actually an admitted student. She said, quote, "Honestly, I just emailed a few professors and personalized my cover letter to their research papers. But I was very lucky because I only had to send about 6 emails and I already got 2 offers. But some friends who are equally qualified, if not more, sent 100 plus emails." So from that, we know that it's okay, you know, you just have to send as many emails as you need to. And also something to keep in mind is that you want to tailor your cold emails to the interests of the professor. So make sure you actually do your research before you send out these emails. You want to know exactly what the professor is up to and be able to match your email to the professor's work so that you actually show that you truly care about what they're doing and that you're excited to be a part of it. And also, don't forget to mention in your cold email what you can offer to the professor. Believe it or not, as a high school student, you actually have a lot to contribute. You bring a different perspective because you are younger than these graduate students or professors who are much older, so you can bring a lot of that innovation in, and you can definitely talk about that in your email. You can also talk about the previous science experiences that you've had, whether that was going to a science competition or taking a science class, and how through those experiences you developed your skills and how you're excited to put those skills to use in that professor's lab. So in your cold emails, number one, make sure you talk directly about why you're interested in that professor's research, and two, what you can bring to the table. And finally, just don't give up with those cold emails. Keep sending them. It doesn't matter if you have to send 100 plus, you will get one in the end. All right, tip number three for finding research opportunities as a high school student is to network with teachers at your school. So your teachers are adults, and adults have a lot of connections. And Casey, my friend who was in that Stanford student series, he said, "For my research opportunities, I was very lucky to be 15 minutes from a research university, University of California, Irvine. So I had a research mentor who was a chemistry graduate student helping me with some research projects for various competitions. I was able to connect with him through a science teacher at my high school. I also had 2 mentors who were PhD students at UCLA last year, who I was able to connect to through the California Nanosystem Institute's Nanovation competition at UCLA. I also look for research opportunities by looking up various programs at the closest university, and I could easily find a couple programs." So again, I think Casey's experience kind of just combines what we already talked about with finding programs, but also with like networking to the adults you already have in your life. So it's definitely helpful to talk to your teachers and ask them if they know any professors who's looking for high school students. And the bonus for that is that your teacher can vouch for you, right? Like if they see that you're a hardworking student and that you are engaged, they're likely gonna say that to the professor, and the professor will be more likely to take you on as a potential intern or a student in their lab. And what's even better is if you go out there and go to science competitions and science fairs and get connected with the judges and PhD students there, and if you just kind of start this conversation with them, they will most likely take interest in you as well. And just from sharing what you like to do and what you're interested in, these opportunities will come to you. So definitely network with the adults that you already know in your life. And fourth, we already talked about this a little bit, but network through science fairs. So if you're looking for research, it's probably because you're interested in science. And this is from my friend Anwisha, who's actually from Oregon, where I live. She said, start from home, do the simple tasks and ideas you like, explore various fields, and take a couple niche courses if necessary. Once you build up that repertoire, you're going to have a much stronger resume and cover letter too. I did science fairs to start, and I would even network with the judges and things like that. Most of my mentors are graduate students doing research themselves, and I got to know them through science fairs and competitions. Also, I can't even count on like five hands the number of Stanford admits who did ICEF at least once. So ICEF stands for Intel Science Engineering Fair, I believe. I might have totally butchered that, but yes, there are so many Stanford admits who did ICEF, which is that science competition or science fair. And it seems like a lot of the judges there will be graduate students or PhD students. And because they're graduate and PhD students, they will be working on research of their own. And a lot of the times they're looking for people to help them with their research. So if you can just offer your enthusiasm and interest and show that you're dedicated and enthusiastic, then they're really likely to take you on as a potential mentee. So yeah, I think to conclude, so number one, look online for programs matching high school students with mentors to do research. Number two, cold email, and don't give up on cold emails. Number three, network with teachers at your school. And number four, network through science fairs and the people there. I have linked my friends' Instagrams in the description, as well as Bullseye Admissions, which is a great resource for getting personalized mentorship. Like this video if you found it helpful, and subscribe for more videos. I think I'm gonna upload daily this week, so let's go. Yeah, some really exciting content coming up with how to find summer jobs and internships, as well as how I actually applied to college twice and got rejected to like from like every single school the first time, but then got in later. So yeah, stay tuned for those, and I'll see you next time. Bye.